Hello and welcome. My name is Javier Rivera, and next in our DTF series, we're going to be doing daily maintenance on an XP15000. This is the maintenance that I do before I print, okay? So I know the title is daily maintenance, but I don't do this every day. If my printer sits for a week, it sits for a week. So I don't do this every day. Now, stay tuned at the end. I'm going to give you a couple of tips and hints, like I always do. So without further ado, let's go ahead. Let's get it started. All right, guys, so to start all our maintenance, the first thing that we're going to do, of course, is we're going to grab our shop towel and we're going to fold it in half longwise, and then we're going to fold it again. Okay. All right. And we're going to keep this on the side. Now, this is my waste tank. We need to not only release this print head to move it to be able to do this, we also need to release pretty much the waste tank and open up for us to be able to clean the capping station. So if you see right now, if I try to create any suction, it's not gonna allow me to create suction. And that is because my waste tank right now, it's not open. So that pump is not open. So we need to do a printhead cleaning. And as soon as we see that cartridge move to the side, that's where we're going to go ahead and pretty much disconnect the power, okay? All right, so then now we're going to grab our shop towel, then we move to the side. And we're gonna put it here. And now, right there, okay? Now we're going to grab our cleaning solution, all right? If you guys go to my channel, there is a video on how to make it. And we're just going to get this damp. We are not going to go crazy with it, okay? Because if you get water or a solution on these rollers right here, next time that you print, you're gonna have lines in your print, okay? So we're just gonna get this damp. Now we're going to move our print head. All right, and now what we're going to do is we're just gonna go on a back and forth motion, all right? And that's what we're gonna do to clean our printhead daily, okay? This is our daily maintenance. I do not remove my printhead, okay? So I'm just gonna do that. Now I'm gonna move this to the side, okay? I do not remove the cartridges. I don't do anything. Once in a while, I'll remove them to make sure that they're not like overflowing and I don't have to clean, but I don't do this, okay? And now what I'm going to do is to our capping station. So now I'm going to grab solution and pretty much dump solution in my capping station until it's about to overflow. And then now, if you guys notice, I can actually see create suction and get that out of there. Another thing that we can do is grab a shop towel, grab a piece of a shop towel. And just with a piece of a shop towel, we can just clean right on the top of our capping station, okay? Very carefully, very slowly. And now the last thing that I do is I use these guys right here to clean my squeegee. So then I'm gonna grab a little bit of cleaning solution, okay? And I'm gonna go to my squeegee. And you're gonna get good at this. It's to the point that now I know exactly when the squeegee is up. Okay, so I like to do it when the squeegee is up. All right, and that's pretty much it. Now make sure that you always create enough suction. Get all that waste ink out of there. All right. All right, so now I am going to remove this towel after we did all this, okay? And now I am going to power on, and then I'm gonna do a couple of printhead cleanings. Usually I will do around three, and then I'll do a print test page and pretty much make sure that everything looks good. And then if I need to keep doing, I will do a maximum of 8 to 10 before I let the printer, just take a rest. But usually I never really need to do more than 8. And then I get a good clean print. And as you can see, this printer is actually pretty dirty because, you know what, I'd rather, you know, as long as it's printing fine, I'd rather not do a lot of stuff. And this has been the Frankenstein, so there's just stuff everywhere. It works fine. It works perfect. I have no issues. And again, this has been my maintenance program that I do every time before I print. There you have it, guys. This is what I do before I'm going to print. This is not my daily maintenance. I don't do daily maintenance. The key that I can tell you that works for me is I don't turn my printers off. I leave them on. And the reason why is your printer is programmed to go to sleep and barely take any power. And then every so often, it's going to wake up. It's going to bring the squeegee up and do a small printhead cleaning right on top of it. And that's going to prevent me from getting clogs. Now, it's not going to avoid the clogs, but it's going to help me not develop a clog in the printhead. So that is the best advice that I can give you. Just don't turn your printer off, okay? If you want to do more maintenance than what I showed you, that is perfectly fine. Just don't turn the printer off. It's going to help you. You will see. So try that. That's the best advice I can give you. Now, I don't do wet capping because I don't want to separate the ink with the solution and leave ink on the bottom, because then it'll get solid and then you'll have these little chunks of rubber that come out of it. I have seen those pumps get clogged because of it, okay? So just be mindful of that. I don't do that. If you do wet capping, it works for you, great. For me, I don't like it. I haven't had any need for wet capping, okay? So again, hopefully this works for you guys. If you got any comments, you know, leave me a comment. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Don't forget to subscribe. And like always, thank you for watching.